Hydrogen. It's literally the most abundant element in the universe. It's essential for life on Earth. It fuels the sun, which converts hundreds of millions of tons of hydrogen into helium every second. When used for fuel here on Earth, it emits nothing but water. Sounds like a miracle fuel for clean energy, right? So why hasn't hydrogen fuel taken off over the last few decades the way electric vehicles that are powered by batteries have? Well, roadblocks like high production costs, lack of charging infrastructure, not to mention challenges in gathering, storing, and transporting hydrogen, have led EV leaders like Elon Musk to dub hydrogen the fool's cell. But thanks to one company, Plasma Kinetics, and their breakthrough solid-state hydrogen technology, which literally stores energy on tape, could hydrogen fuel finally overcome these obstacles and become the energy breakthrough we've all been promised all these years? We thought these questions and this technology deserved a deeper dive here on Two Bit da Vinci. Special thanks to Truebill for sponsoring this video, the all-in-one finance app that helps you budget like a boss and lower your bills. So let's talk hydrogen. Being one of the most abundant materials in the universe, it's always been long held out as a promising alternative to fossil fuels. And there's a good reason for that. It's an inherently clean energy source with no adverse environmental impacts, as its byproducts are typically nothing more than heat and water. NASA has even experimented with using hydrogen to fuel various space projects, utilizing the water produced in the process as potable drinking water for astronauts. Hydrogen is also incredibly energy dense, around 3 times more than fossil fuels and other natural gases by weight. Hydrogen fuel, which powers hydrogen fuel cells, is also far more efficient than gasoline-powered engines, as it's far better at converting energy, which can then be sent to vastly more efficient electric motors. The best part is, they produce no greenhouse gases, which of course is the ultimate goal with alternative fuels. But as great as hydrogen fuel cells have proven to be, there are several reasons why they haven't made a big splash in the mainstream. For one thing, while hydrogen itself may be an abundant material, it doesn't ever really hang out by itself, at least not here on Earth. Because it's so light, pure hydrogen typically floats off into space. So the hydrogen we use is always bonded with other elements. Getting pure hydrogen to use as fuel can be done in a handful of ways. There's the clean but expensive method called electrolysis, which involves using electricity to split water into its two components, hydrogen and oxygen. The cheaper, much dirtier way actually starts with fossil fuel. In steam methane reforming, methane reacts with steam under 3 to 25 bars of pressure in the presence of a catalyst to produce hydrogen, carbon monoxide, and a relatively small amount of carbon dioxide. This is one of those dirty little secrets that hydrogen proponents would rather you not think about. These aspects drive up the cost of hydrogen extraction while also reducing its overall environmental benefit. Then there's transportation. Hydrogen is extremely flammable, and being such a small element in gas form under normal conditions, needs to be compressed significantly. The Toyota Mirai, for example, stores its hydrogen at 10,000 psi. This makes it difficult and dangerous to move around, which is why most hydrogen production happens right at the location where it's going to be used. On this channel, we often talk about how every technology has pros and cons, and hydrogen is no different. Though it has some deficits, it still has found some niches, mostly in the industrial sector, as well, rocket fuel. But if it wants to gain more proliferation, it's going to have to overcome some serious limitations. And that's where Plasma Kinetics comes in. Their proprietary technology may provide a one-stop shop solution to capture, store, and even transport hydrogen. Best of all, the company claims that its technology is cheaper, safer, and better than their competitors, including lithium ion. What is this breakthrough hydrogen technology? Well, to help break it down, let's cast our memories back to a time before smartphones, before CD players, to the era of cassette tapes. That's right, Plasma Kinetics technology essentially stores hydrogen on tape. Well, light-activated nanostructured thin film, to be exact. So, how does it work? The material itself is a nanographite magnesium hydride film, about 1/10 the thickness of a human hair. The film is covered in billions of tiny, negatively charged points covering its surface. Hydrogen, if you remember back in your high school chemistry class, is positively charged. When exposed to greenhouse gases like exhaust from, say, a smokestack, the film can capture metric tons of pure hydrogen from the steam without using any electricity. The reason the company chose magnesium as a primary ingredient is that it's the element plants use in nature during photosynthesis to store light energy. We've done a whole video on artificial photosynthesis, which you can check out here. Before I get back to the show, let me tell you about our sponsor, Truebill. Truebill is the all-in-one finance app that's like having a personal assistant in your pocket. For one, it'll monitor your accounts and find subscriptions that you might not even need, like a cloud storage service that I stopped using nearly a year ago, and a streaming service I guess I forgot to cancel after the trial. Whoops. I also love how easy Truebill makes it to set up a budget and track my spending by various categories. I tend to dig into the data when I'm doing well. When I'm following my diet, I weigh myself every morning. But after a few cheat days, not so much. Finances are the same way. But trust me, shining a spotlight on the important aspects of your life really works. Plus, I'm officially in the market for a home, which means lenders pulling my credit report. With Truebill, I got a notification saying there was activity on my credit report score almost immediately. That peace of mind makes me feel like I have someone who's got my back, looking out for me. There are services that offer these various benefits, but few bring them all together like Truebill. So help support our show and your finances by getting started with Truebill today. Head over to www.truebill.com/2bitdaVinci or click on the link in the video description. Big thank you to Truebill and all of you for supporting the show. The company's founder, Paul Smith, has a background in building computer chips, where, according to Smith, engineers try to layer up materials and get the conductivity the way they want it. In designing the thin film, Smith and his team applied several principles, layering up negatively charged materials that are naturally attractive to hydrogen. To release the hydrogen, the film is exposed to light, which changes the polarity of the bonds, becoming positively charged instead of negative. Once the bonds change, the hydrogen is released, much like the laser shines on an old CD to release music. You do remember CDs, right? PK's initial design looked much like a CD player, with the nanofilm in the form of a disc. But the company realized that you're going to get far more surface area in the form of a film roll. One cassette of the hydrogen-filled film would offer roughly the same amount of fuel as a 5,000 PSI hydrogen tank, but without consuming any extra energy for compression or extraction. The process is almost 100% carbon-free, a claim that few other companies can make. While the systems wouldn't be rechargeable like an EV, they could easily be swapped out within a matter of minutes, literally like a cassette tape. The canisters themselves would be reusable up to 1,000 cycles and could be charged within a matter of minutes by green product sites like municipal water treatment facilities or incineration facilities. And once the canister is officially tapped out, each component is 100% recyclable. You might be thinking, why haven't we heard of this technology? Well, the truth is the company created this tech almost 20 years ago. And at the time, the DOE, the Department of Energy, recognized the technology's potential for good. However, there's a pretty big overlap between energy production and national security, especially when it comes to hydrogen. I'm sure we can all think of one or two ways for hydrogen to cause some serious damage. So the company was actually barred from receiving patents from the US government from 2008 until 2017. Now, the company has one restriction. They can't export the tech for missile fuel. So that's a good thing. Anyway, let's talk power. How would this energy on tape compare to other battery technology? These numbers are to be taken with a grain of salt, as the technology is still in development. I know that's another thing we say all the time on this channel. In terms of energy density, a Tesla battery gets about 265 watt-hours per kilogram and 730 watt-hours per liter. Compressed hydrogen gets significantly more at between 530 and 960 watt-hours per kilogram and over 1,200 watt-hours per liter. Plasma Kinetics light-activated solid-state fuel cells fall somewhere in the middle, between 380 and 500 watt-hours per kilogram or over 1,000 watt-hours per liter, to give about the same range as a Tesla battery. But the company claims that their technology is about 200% longer lasting than batteries and about 15 to 20% cheaper to produce and maintain than other battery and fuel cell technology. The technology is also significantly lighter than other technology out there today, meaning it could present a viable option for commercial vehicles as well as aviation. And because it doesn't use any precious materials, it could see wider applications so that lithium ion can stay reserved for things like phones, computers, and EV technology. Of course, there are a handful of drawbacks. For one, as we mentioned above, the tech wouldn't be rechargeable in the way we typically think of a plug-in EV. Though the cells would be reusable and easily swappable, they'd have to be removed and taken to a separate facility to gain more hydrogen. There's also the issue that the way these batteries get hydrogen is through the exhaust waste of other technology, meaning it sort of requires greenhouse gases. So while it doesn't produce any carbon itself, it still requires exhaust. Finding a way to gather hydrogen using this technology with absolutely no emissions would be a real challenge, but maybe in the future, engineers could accomplish this. For now, the technology is still in development, as we mentioned above, but if this company can roll out and show that it's truly as simple and effective as they claim, we may start seeing more and more cars fitted with some sweet hydrogen tape decks. But what do you think? Should we get excited about this new hydrogen fuel cell, or is it just more pie in the sky daydreaming? Let us know in the comments below. All right, so that is a look at the solid state hydrogen tape pack. It's a really exciting technology, I will say. There's a million things they need to prove out as far as reliability and how many times. They've mentioned 1,000 cycles. That may or may not be true. Degradation, just sitting around, if they're safe. Other considerations that we haven't thought about. They are in moving vehicles, potentially. But I do think it's pretty exciting stuff. And I'm wishing them luck. I hope they make some better breakthroughs in the next couple of years. A huge thank you to all of you for watching. Thank you so much. If you want to be a rockstar supporter of this show, please consider joining us as a 2-Bit Tribe member, either as a patron on Patreon or as a YouTube channel member. Come chat with us on Discord, hang out with other like-minded people who believe the future is going to be awesome. Help us write scripts, plan ideas and stories and future trips, all with a monthly contribution and with no obligations long-term. Thank you so much to all of you for watching. I'm Ricky with Two Bit da Vinci. And if nothing else, just remember the future is going to be awesome.